Welcome to the University of Maryland University College's CMST 320 Illustration Graphics class. In this short tutorial, we'll be going over the requirements of your first project due in week one, the diagram assignment. So before watching this tutorial, however, please make sure to complete any readings or other video tutorials that are listed in the week one module. The material in those videos and those readings cover some of the basics of Adobe Illustrator that you'll need to know for this assignment. So what I wanted to do in this quick tutorial is not go step by step with you on how I created it, but in fact just point out with this very simple little diagram how I met the requirements of diagram assignment number one. So we'll go through not necessarily in order, but in kind of how I created this and using just basic shape tools, the paintbrush, text, etc. to meet the requirements. So the first thing I did was to create these basically square boxes to meet the most basic of requirements by using the drawing tool. So coming over to the drawing tool, the toolbar, choosing the rectangle tool, making squares, and filling those in. Now, of course, one of the requirements is to use fills and strokes as well. So if you do that right away by drawing your first box, you will have met that requirement. Use the tool, use the fill. This is your fill color box area. This is your stroke color area. And so just really quickly, we can add a fill and stroke to this basic shape that I just made, just making a square. Again, zooming in a little bit. We've just got a tan square with a red outline, or stroke, as it's called in Illustrator. And that meets a couple of your requirements. So I'm going to delete that. Just so you can see, that's what I did to create those shapes and begin a simple diagram with three simple steps, basically what it takes for me to get ready to go to work. We left out getting the kids to school and the second cup of coffee, which was somewhere around in here, but that's not going to fit this diagram. So what else do we need to do for this assignment? We need to add text. So that makes sense. If you're making a diagram, right, whether it's steps on a map, how to create a server, whatever diagram you choose, it would make sense that we put text in there to describe each step along the way. So this is just using the text tool, and basically once you choose that tool from the toolbar, you click anywhere in your document and begin writing. After having done that, we've created several different text areas. I copied and pasted those to create our text steps to meet that requirement as well. And the last couple things besides saving the file is to design your own icons to use in the diagram and apply transforming objects. So I'm going to show you what I did here just by showing you, zooming in a little bit to the thumbs up icon that I made. And basically I just did this by using the rounded rectangle tool. All these shapes within this hand are basically used just by using the rounded rectangle tool. So that's got a fill of black now, but you can see if I would go step by step, we could easily change the color of this and build that out just by using this simple tool and creating simple shapes in Illustrator. Give that an outline. So if I continue that, you could see that's how we built the hands here in Illustrator. I gave them a drop shadow just to add a little depth to it. But for right now, I just dragged it in three times to create the two thumbs up and the thumbs down icon. But how do we get to the thumbs down? Well, that's where the transforming object step came into play, meeting, again, the next requirement for this assignment. So if I were to just drag in a thumbs up icon, enlarge it a little bit, and then go up to Object, Transform, and Reflect. What that does right away is, as Preview is chosen, if it wasn't, you wouldn't see any change here, but Preview was chosen, so we can see the effect right away just by choosing this. We choose a horizontal flip or reflect, and click OK, and that's how it stays. So that's meeting the requirement for that step in this assignment as well. So before we talk about saving and exporting your document. Just wanted to point out a few couple things. Again, with this diagram, I hope yours may be a little more intricate or at least a little more exciting than this. But I just use very simple shapes, circles, ellipses, rectangles, squares, and rounded rectangles, of course, to create this very simple document. Even the brow on the upset step 3 is just a yellow rectangle. Again, a very simple step to just show that an Illustrator, all it is working with shapes, making them work for you to create the image you want. And as we go on in this course, of course, you will see that Illustrator is so much more robust than that, and you'll be able to create many more great things. So let's talk about saving your document. Obviously, you're going to go to File and Save. This is covered in one of your Adobe Illustrator tutorials. And I like to go to Save As. And right away, usually Adobe Illustrator, the AI file, is already chosen. And mine is titled razor.diagramassignment.ai. And you would save that as your AI file requirement. And to save your PDF to send along as well, again, you just choose that option here in the format toolbar. And the last thing I wanted to point out before closing this diagram assignment tutorial is to talk about converting your text to outline. Now, one of the reasons why there's a requirement to send your artwork as a PDF is just in case in your steps to save your document, if you just send an AI document and I open it here at my house, or a printer opens it to print your work, and they do not have the funky font that you chose. I chose something called Neuropol X Free. If they do not have that font, what they're going to get is a generic fill font that is not going to look like what you want it to look like, or print exactly the way you want it to, because they might not have that font or that type in their computer. So what you have to do in order to make sure that your work looks the way you want it to is convert your text to outlines. Now, what you'd want to do that is go to Type and Create Outlines. I'm not going to do that step just yet, because what I want to do is talk about non-destructive editing. And what that means is maybe someday I want to get back into this document and change this text. I realize the printer or my client doesn't like the colloquialism of getting to work, and I need to title it Getting to Work. I can just make that change real quick and then be able to create it to outlines and export it again like I want to. If I didn't do this step, this next step before doing that, I wouldn't be able to change the text. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to make a duplicate of this text area. So just copy, paste in front. And then what we're going to do, what you see now, is we have two text layers that are exactly the same. What we're going to do is keep the back layer where it is, but we're going to hide it. It's going to be there, it's just not going to be able to be seen. We're going to choose the top text layer, and that's what we're going to convert to outlines. So when we do that, what you see is Adobe creates this path outline of the exact font that you used in your document, ensuring that when a printer or an instructor opens your document, they're going to see the text that you want them to see without missing any fonts from their system. So that's a key step as you think ahead of using these type of documents to send to printers or to a client or to an instructor who has a lot of fonts, is a font geek, but doesn't have everything. So make sure you do that step. So anyways, this comes to a conclusion, guys. Good luck on your diagram assignment. And if you get, again, if you have any questions leading up to when it is due or after, whenever, please send an email along. Thanks again for watching.